the pros and cons about living here in Bellingham, the good, the bad, and the ugly. And in this video, I'm gonna talk about all that here. Now, if for those of you that don't know me, my name is Aldo. I'm a local realtor here with the Levain Real Estate Team with Windermere. And if you're new to this channel, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. Hit the bell, as every week we shoot videos talking about what it's like living, breathing, playing, and eating here all in Bellingham and the surrounding areas. We also get calls, text messages, and emails every single week from people like you looking at moving to Bellingham or the surrounding areas. So if you're in the market and you're looking at buying a house and you need some help, feel free. All my information is down below. Give us a call, shoot us a text or an email, and we'll be more than happy to help you guys out. Now, before we get into the list of the pros and cons, I moved here when I was about 7 years old with my parents. And so I grew up here from second grade all the way through high school. So I've lived here all my life. After high school, didn't go to college. I stayed around here for a little bit. I went and traveled around, but just kept coming back to Bellingham. And thankfully, because I was young and didn't have much money, I was able to move around to a lot of different places here in Bellingham. So not only did I know what Bellingham was like as a kid, but as a younger adult, I really got to know what Bellingham was like. And it's really nice to see that Bellingham has grown, but with growth comes the good and comes with the bad. So let's get right into the list. So my number one pro here about living in Bellingham is gotta be the outdoors. Now I get it, you probably already Googled it, and the number one thing says the outdoors, and I feel like I'm beating a dead horse here, but you can't understand it until you really move here. And the outdoors here are amazing. Now in the winter time, if you love to ski or snowboard or go sledding or be around the snow, Mount Baker is about an hour away from us. And Mount Baker has a record for the most snowfall here, or snowfall in America in its history. So we get a lot of snow, and you're gonna have 4 or 5 months of skiing and snowboarding here, and it's gonna be phenomenal. Now, in the spring and summertime, you can go up to Mount Baker, go to Artist Point and hike around. The scenery is beautiful. Not only that, but in Bellingham and the surrounding areas, we have a lot of lakes, we have a lot of rivers. So if you want to go hiking, you want to go camping, you just want to be outside, if you want to go down by the boardwalk to Bellingham and walk along the bay, you can do that as well. Bellingham is located between the mountains and the bay, and we're just in a great little spot out here, so you can do everything outside. Now, for those of you that aren't as adventurous and don't love to hike and bike and do all these crazy outdoor activities, which I get because I'm not a big camper myself, there is so much to do just by being outside. If you have kids, there's a lot of parks here. Bellingham has invested a lot of money in opening up new parks here with some water features, new parks in Cordata, in the Squalicum Park. Now, downtown Bellingham by the bay has opened up a new park with a pump track. There's a lot of cool things. And we have a lot of breweries here in Bellingham. It is crazy. If you've heard how crazy it is in Portland, just imagine a little smaller version here. We have so many breweries where it caters to being outside. So if you love going out and having a beer by yourself, with your spouse, and with your kids, most breweries will let you bring your kids and be outside and having a good time. So not just for those outdoor adventurers, but everybody that is looking to just be outside during those peak summer times, it is phenomenal, because in the summertime, the sun will probably rise around 4:30 in the morning and probably doesn't go down till 10 p.m. So you have really long days, which make it amazing to be here in Bellingham. Now for pro number two, it's gotta be the location. So let me explain this a little bit. I know I already told you that we're located between the mountains and the bay, but Bellingham is situated about an hour and 20 minutes north of Seattle, all right? And it's about 20 minutes to the Canadian border, but probably maybe 40 or 50 minutes south of BC, of Vancouver, BC, which you have two major metropolitan areas, and we're right in the middle of it. And we don't have that craziness or that traffic-wise in Bellingham. If you're at a stoplight, you're probably gonna get through on the next light. I mean, the traffic here is very, very minimal. For us to go from one end of Bellingham to the other, maybe with traffic, 15 to 20 minutes max. So it's really great. Now, location here. If you are wanting to go up to Canada, you can do so. Go down to Seattle, you can do so. Now, if you wanna go up to Whistler, it's about a 3-hour drive. If you wanna go over to the mountains and go to Leavenworth, that's about a 3-hour drive as well. So we are really nice and tucked in this little middle of things that you can do. So if you get tired of being here in Bellingham and you want to go enjoy the big city in Seattle, go for it. Go see a Seahawks game. Go see a Kraken game or Mariners game. It's not that far. So there is just, we're just tucked in this great location. And how many people can say they literally live right on the water? We're right on Bellingham Bay. We do have Lake Whatcom and Lake Patton. We have a lot of things that you can be doing outside or inside. So we have the amenities here in Bellingham. We just aren't as big as some of these bigger cities. Okay, so for the third pro is Bellingham has a sense of community. Now, we were talking about the population of only being 100,000 people. Well, Bellingham is a very hyper-local community. And let me explain what I mean by that. And people love to support local businesses. Yes, we have a Costco here. We have a Fred Meyer. We have some bigger stores, the Target, and so on and so forth. But if you have a small business, whether it's an eatery, a restaurant, or even a little nursery, people are going to come and support you. People here in Bellingham are really nice people. In the summertime here in Bellingham, we have so many festivals. We have Downtown Sounds, which is a huge festival for everybody. They have beer, local food, local restaurants that will come in with their food trucks, and people can just hang around and feel like they're part of the community. We have a lot of farmers markets. We have a lot more beer festivals throughout the summertime as well. So Whatcom County as a whole, the population is maybe 200,000 people, and Bellingham about 100,000 people. So you have a good sized city, but you feel like you're involved with the community. Everybody doesn't know everybody, but you feel like you're going somewhere, you're going to support somebody. Our Facebook and Instagram groups, people are always asking for help, and our community is always there to back them up. And for the last pro here in Bellingham is my personal favorite is there's a lot of golfing. If you want more of a private area, we do have a Bellingham Golf and Country Club. I have a private club there, but we also have a Shucks and Golf Course, which has different elevations, which is really nice. And the scenery there is beautiful. Loomis Golf Course, I think, is one of the top 15 or so golf courses in the state. If you go up north to Blaine, Semiyamu Country Club as well. We also have some other more public that I think are really top favorites here, Lake Patton, even a 9-hole course here in Linden for Raspberry. So we have a lot of golfing, whether you want to go north or south, and it's just great. Here's a bonus pro as well. There's a lot to do with kids. Jasmine and I have a 2-year-old, so if you're looking at doing things with your kids, very kid-friendly here in Bellingham, which is awesome, which I love. And another bonus tip, I don't know if I mentioned, but we do have Galbraith. I feel like Bellingham's like the Mecca mountain biking capital of the world. Galbraith, people come here from all over the world to come and just mountain bike here. Yeah, just a few more reasons. I mean, I could go on and on and on about how many great things there are here in Bellingham. Now, with all that sunshine and all outdoor activities and having these long days, well, that's the good. And with the good, with our weather comes the bad. And the con number one is going to be our winters, our weather. Now, obviously, March through December, not too bad. Phenomenal summers. December, January, February can be rough. And a lot of people think that it's the rain. And it's really not the rain. We get used to the rain out here. But it's kind of the darker and gloomy days that really hits us. And what I mean by that is the sun probably doesn't rise until maybe 7:45, 8 a.m., you know, in January, February, and it gets dark by like 4 p.m. So we have very short days. We'll have 8 hours. Now, obviously, in return, in the summertime, we have, you know, almost 18-hour days, which is amazing. Our winters can be rough. We don't get a lot of snow. The last couple of years, we've maybe have had 6 or 7 inches for a couple of days at a time, maybe once, maybe twice each year, but that doesn't really hurt us. It's really the dark and gloomy days because we don't get a lot of sun. It's pretty cloudy a lot of the times. Now, November, you have Thanksgiving. December, you have the holidays, Christmas and Hanukkah or anything you celebrate. So all that, all your family, you're cheering, you're having a good time. New Year's hits. January, there's nothing. February, there's nothing. January, February are the toughest 2 months to live here because they are the longest. There's nothing to look forward to. They're wet. They're very, very wet and they're dark and they're cold. If we don't get snow, we're going to have temperatures probably hovering around 35 to 37 degrees. And if it's rainy, being wet and being cold is very, very uncomfortable. Once again, if you can live through those 2 months, once springtime hits here, it is amazing. It's phenomenal. We have the most beautiful spring and the most beautiful fall. Fall here is probably one of people's favorite area because you can finally just settle down because our summers have been really hot lately and settle down and just cozy on up with a nice little latte or whatnot. So now with having such a great location does come with one of the biggest cons here while living in Bellingham or if you're moving here, and that's affordability. The price to live here in Bellingham is going to be more expensive, probably even if you were living in Seattle or Bellevue area. Our gas, groceries, or more of your necessities that you're needing is going to cost you more than the average. The average home in Whatcom County is about $650,000. In Bellingham, you're probably more about $750,000. There is people that are coming to Bellingham and they're moving up from Seattle, they're moving up from California, from Texas, from Montana, from Idaho, because we have such a great location with all four seasons. You're gonna get a true season every single quarter. And it's making housing here very expensive. So our income to real estate home prices is very, very big. And the average income here in Bellingham is somewhere around $62,000, $65,000. And our average home is almost nine times that. So it does get pretty difficult to purchase a home here because Bellingham's just only getting bigger and bigger. So earlier I mentioned that our population has grown and it has just become a bigger area since I was a kid. And with that does come the ugly. So the biggest con, the third con, and the ugliest part about living here in Bellingham is what we have seen in the last couple of years. And we have seen a lot more theft, a lot more drug use, and a lot more homelessness. Now, here in Bellingham, we see it more than some of the outer areas just because we're the closest city and the more south city here in our area. And we have seen a lot more homelessness. The drug use here on the streets has been a problem, and so has theft, particularly in bicycles. But there's a lot more theft. We don't have shootings like we do or murders like we do in other areas or a lot of them. No area is perfect. We don't live in a little utopia and everything's just going to be smooth and amazing and perfect. Now, it hasn't personally affected me yet. And I know it has affected quite a bit of people in this area. But what we have seen is we have seen more people moving into Bellingham than we have seen people moving out of Bellingham, let alone even Washington. Yes, there are people that don't agree with things happening here in our own state that are leaving maybe to Texas or California or Florida. But there's a lot of people that are moving into this area because of what I have talked about here in the previous video with the location, with the weather. There's so much to do. So yes, the crime and the homelessness and the drug use hasn't hit like it has hit in Seattle. And hopefully we do get that all fixed or bring it down low. Like I said, want to be 100% transparent. That is the biggest con about this area. It's not happening everywhere in Bellingham. Just something to be aware of. Okay, let's finish with the last con. Once again, my personal con that I have here in Bellingham, and that's our food. Our food's very average. Now, for anybody watching this, you could disagree with me, and I totally get it. So please leave me some places down below on where I should try. I feel as a real estate agent, I eat out quite a bit. And let me explain why I feel like our food is average. It's not because our food doesn't taste good. I mean, if you go to breweries around here, they have great burgers, great hot dogs. The food tastes good, but we just don't have much diversity here. We don't have a great Mexican restaurant or Chinese or Italian place or really anything that's more diverse than your traditional American food here. And when it comes to fine dining as well, don't have a lot of places to go there as well. I mean, there's a couple of places on the water. One of Jasmine and I's favorite places is Keenan's at the pier, good food, great scenery, but once again, their food isn't top notch. There's not a lot of places here in Bellingham where you're like, hey, I'm going there every single week because their food is that good. Don't get me wrong, the food here is good. We just don't have a lot of diversity, not much Indian food or a lot of cultural food that we don't have. Where if you go down to Seattle or maybe across the mountains, you will see more diversity into there where you will see a lot more food, or Chicago or New York. Obviously, those are big, big areas. But yeah, our food here, I would say, is average and nothing crazy, crazy good. So those are all the pros and cons I have about living here in Bellingham. Those are my personal pros and cons. So if you're watching this video, let me know if I missed anything big, pro, or con wise, leave them in the comments down below. And for those of you that are actually looking at moving here to Bellingham, give us a call, shoot us a text message or an email. Day, night, morning, weekends, we have your back. Let us know a little bit more about your lifestyle or what amenities will fit for you guys or what you're needing. That way we can help you place you in the right area here in Bellingham or anywhere in the county. Once again, guys, my name is Aldo. I am here with the Levain Real Estate Team, and we'll see you next time.